Listen, listen, students, okay? This is our concept number 12. This is our concept number 12, rounding off. Please understand. Concept of rounding off is given in section 288A and section 288B. Okay, there are two sections in income tax which talks about rounding off. And rounding off of total income is also there, and rounding off of tax liability. So you have to do two times a rounding off. Rounding, when total income comes, that also has to be rounded off. And then tax liability, the final tax figure that we are computing since morning, that amount also has to be rounded off in a multiple of 10 rupees. Please remember, you are going to write GST paper also. Alright, in GST paper, rounding off of 1 rupee is there, and in income tax, rounding off of 10 rupees is there. This also can become MCQ. Alright, in income tax, rounding off of dash amount, 10 rupees. Hello, in GST, rounding off of 1 rupee. So, both laws are following their own rounding off principle, and therefore, whenever the tax liability is, say, for example, last figure is 524, so you should ignore 4 rupees, and if it is 525, you should rounded off to higher number. What is the rounding off figure for this? 520. What is the rounding off figure for this? 530. So income tax people, they don't take change amount. Okay, that coins they don't take. They don't like coins. Either they ignore it or they take full amount. Alright. So up to 4.99 paisa, they will ignore. Up to, if this last figure is 4.99 paisa, they will ignore. The moment that number touch to 5 rupees. Okay. 5 rupees onwards, they take full number, higher side, rounding up to the higher side. Up to 4.99 paisa, rounding up to lower side. Okay, yes, so that is rounding up principle. Please write down, total income and tax liability shall be rounded off in a multiple of rupees 10. Okay. This is section 288A and 288B. Listen, we are about to done with this chapter except section 9. There are 5-6 more concepts which are very small. Allow me to explain in one shot itself. Okay. Other relevant basic concepts. But don't write this. Don't write this. I'll tell you when you have to write it. After section 9. First we have to write section 9. Basic concepts. Other relevant provisions. In my law, I'll be using, or even law faculty will be using, and many people use this word proviso. Okay. Now there are two types of pronunciation. You people call it proviso or proviso. Whatever pronunciation you follow, proviso means what? So proviso is exception to provision. Proviso is an exception to provision. Provision means law, rule. All right. Proviso is an exception, minus to that particular law. Hello. Then in law, I will show you proviso to proviso, exception to exception. Exception to exception becomes law. Hello. Law minus something. So that is minus. Minus minus plus. Okay. Minus minus plus. So minus minus will become law. Okay. So that we need to discuss. Proviso at two different level. Alright. So what is proviso, sir? Proviso to a section spells out the exception to the provision. Exception to the provision. This word is very important. This word you need to write in reading. It is an exception. Okay, you can underline that word in your book. Proviso to a section spells out the exception to the provision contained in the respective section. Alright, so I will teach you personally proviso to section 48. So that time you should understand I'm teaching you exception to section 48. Okay, then there are explanation into law. Okay. So sometime I will be saying that this is written in explanation 1, this is written in explanation 2. You feel that I am giving that explanation. I am not giving that explanation. Your institute is also not giving that explanation. Lawmakers have given that explanation. That explanation was approved in parliament. It's a part of law. It's an extension of section. Hello. So they write this. Explanation to section gives a clarification. What is the more important word here? Clarification. Clarification relating to the provision contained in the respective section. So you understood difference between proviso and exception. It has asked in CA exam. discuss what is proviso and what is explanation. So you need to write this one line and there one example, one or two examples. You will get lot of examples in law. Right now we don't have because I did not teach you law. Law will start from tomorrow. Alright. But as of now you should understand this much. Okay. Explanation to section gives clarification. So give us explanation, some explanation. Yes, explanation 1 and 2 to explain to section 37 one I will be teaching you. Explanation to section 43 one I will be teaching you. Alright. So that will come in law. Then there is something called provided. Okay. This word, provided word creates a condition. Provided word creates a condition. So now you people are tired, you will seek for a break. I'll give you break provided we are done with section 9. So what I said, I'll give you break, but there is a condition. What is the condition? We should be done with section 9. So even in law also they will say, exemption is given, deduction is given, provided. The word provided provides a condition. Okay. So the term provided creates a condition in the respective section. Okay. Now there is one more definition that you will understand in a better manner when we are actually done with basic provisions of income tax. Okay. And that term is assessee. Sometime in exam it comes as a short note. Define assessee, explain assessee. Alright, what is assessee? Alright. So assessee is the person which has some dealing with income tax department. Some either you have to pay tax or interest or penalty or fee. There are four words. Either you are liable to pay this much or you are about to get interest or refund from income tax department. Hello. So either you are payable to income tax department or you are receivable to income tax department. In both cases you are an assessee to department. And then in department we are having two amazing level of assessee. One is a deemed assessee. Deemed assessee means assessee which is not assessee, but we want you to become assessee. Alright. So you are a foreigner and your cousin is in India or your father is in India. We are unable to recover tax from that guy. Yes. So we will recover tax from your Indian relative. If your HO is in Singapore and your branch is in India, assessee actually located in HO is wherever corporate office is located, that is your assessee. But they have branch in India, we will make that branch as a deemed assessee and we will recover tax from that branch. But that is international taxation. But there is a concept of deemed assessee in my income tax. Okay. So there is actual assessee, there is deemed assessee. Then I told you there is one chapter called TDS. Alright. TDS chapter, tax deducted at source. So I am earning income in this institute. Yes or no? So I am the assessee who is liable to pay tax. But my taxes has to be deducted by institute. Alright, my taxes has to be deducted by institute, elite siksha. If they don't deduct my taxes, alright, then I am not in default. They are in default. So government will not levy penalty on me, Ram Patil, your taxes were not deposited. They did not deposit, penalty is on elite siksha. So they will be called as assessee in default. So there is a terminology, assessee in default. That terminology you will understand in TDS chapter. Okay. So there are three types of assessees we have in income tax. Assessee, deemed assessee and assessee in default. We use this terminology in different scenarios. Okay. Those scenarios. So here what you should understand, that simple definition of assessee. Here I am just teaching a theory. Okay. If it comes in exam, then you write like this. Okay. You will get, if it is for 2 marks, you will get 2 marks for writing this. But if you want to understand properly, then allow to me to finish chapter called TDS. Till that time, you may not understand it clearly, with whole clarity. Okay. So what they are saying, assessee means a person by whom any tax or any other sum of money is payable. Any tax or any other sum of money. What comes in any other sum of money? Interest, penalty, fees. Okay. Money is payable under this act. Assessee also includes. What it includes in assessee? Every person in respect of any proceeding under act has been taken for the assessment. So department has started raid on you or department has started some assessment. Then also you are an assessee because some procedures are going on. Okay. Right now you, everyone sitting here is a person. Yes or no?
Yes.
We all are individual. But you people are not assessee. Why? You people don't have anything with department. Are you liable to pay any tax to department, any penalty, any interest, any proceeding against you is going on in department? No. So you don't get covered under first two clauses. So you are a person but not an assessee. Hello? Okay? Every person who is deemed to be assessee. So there will be a category of deemed to be assessee. And then every person who is deemed to be assessee in default. Hello? Assessee in default. That is in TDS chapter. Okay? Huh. Then what is assessment? Yesterday I told you assessment means assess. Assessment means computation or recomputation of income tax. You compute, that is assessment. When income tax department recompute, that is the reassessment. And therefore they said assessment includes reassessment. Assessment includes?
Yes.
Here, the assessment is the procedure by which an income of an assessee determined by AO. So when assessment is done by individual assessee, we call it self-assessment. Okay? But you cannot pass your order. You can do your assessment and file ITR. Final order will be launched by income tax department. Hello? So look at the terminologies now. The base word is assess. It's a tree. Assess is a tree. Look at the branches of assess word. Okay? Assess. Assessment se kya nikla? Assessment. Assess se kya nikla? Assessment. Assessment kiska hota hai in respect of whom you do assessment? Assessee. Who does assessee? Assessment for assessee. Assessing officer. Hello? Assess, assessment. Assessment will be done for assessee by assessing officer. Assessing officer will pass assessment order in assessment year. Everything is linked with one word, that is assess. Okay? This is how it happens. And assessment also includes reassessment. That reassessment is there in CMA final. So, not now. Definition of income. Okay. That we cannot write because that is more than 3 to 4 page definition. How can I teach you definition of income now? Alright. You, if you want to understand what is income. Because in income tax, what is taxable?
Income.
Income. And the definition of income is more than 2-3 pages. So, I cannot teach you, I cannot give you time to write that definition. If you want to write, you write. But not now, after finishing my syllabus. Right now you will not understand it. Okay? Here you should understand only one word, and it is written in reading that income tax has not provided means definition to us. The definition is inclusive definition. That means AB income hai, OB income hai, OB income hai. And if you bring anything new, even that will become income. Because definition, even income tax doesn't know what is income. They are not sure about it. If they are sure about it, this is the income, then they will provide 3-4 definition. Okay, this is income, this is income, this is income, this is income. And if you earn anything which is not there in the list, then that is not an income, so it won't become taxable. But they are very much smart. They know that assessee is like that, assessee tomorrow will prove this is not an income, so there is no income tax. And therefore the definition is not given in exhaustive manner, definition is given in inclusive manner. This is just a list of illustrative income. If something new you earn, which is not there already in that 3 pages, then even that will also become income. Because definition is not exhaustive, definition is inclusive. Am I clear with this much? Okay. Then what is the average rate of tax? So some people demands for average rate of tax. In FM, see, FM faculty doesn't know this slab and surcharge and cess and marginal relief. FM faculty knows only tax nayar. Okay, so if you solve some FM question, FM, alright, financial management question, you will see tax rate is written 28%. Then you will ask one doubt to your teacher. Sir, 28% ka to tax rate hai nahi desh mein. How do you took, how can you take this 28%? That 28% is not tax rate, it's average tax rate. Okay, on an average they are paying 28% tax. Sir, how do we determine average tax rate? So you know how to determine tax amount by applying all provisions. Slab and surcharge and education cess, rebate, everything. Tax amount divided by total income multiply by 100. Okay, that will be your average tax. You can do anything. Last time how much we determined tax for any assessee? Can you tell me last tax amount after marginal relief? Oh, 50 lakh wale ka kitna aaya tha? 51 lakh wale ka. What was the tax amount of 51 lakh guy? Final amount. Take that amount on Kelsey, 14 lakh. 69,000. 14 lakh 69,000. Take it on Kelsey, 14 lakh 69,000. And uska income kitna tha? What was his total income? 51 lakh. Divide by 51 lakh. Multiply by 100. You tell me. 28. You understood? This is how it comes. Hello? So that's not tax rate. That's Average tax rate, because other people, see, management don't understand all these things. If tomorrow my management calls me, Ram Patil, come here, how much on an average tax we pay? I cannot tell this, sir, 2.5 lakh to 5 nil, then 2.5 lakh to 5 lakh, 5%, then 10%, then 20%, then 30%. If your income exceeds from 50 lakh, you have to pay 10% surcharge. If your income exceeds 100 lakh, you have to pay 15% surcharge. If your income doesn't exceed by 3.5 lakh, you will get rebate of 2,500. And then, sir, do not forget to add 4% cess. And then, sir, you know, final amount that we have to round it off, sir, in multiple of 10. Pagal ho jayenge wo log. Management doesn't understand this. They will say, what I want rate of tax, man, what are you telling me? Okay, sir, you want rate of tax, so tax amount divided by total income, this is, sir, on an average, our company is paying 28%. So this is the decision making tax rate. Income tax ka aur is rate ka koi lena dena nahi hai. Okay, but people demand this rate, so we compute this rate. Okay, cool.
Yes.
Sir, each case may 29, need not to necessarily every case will, some case will be 5%, some case will be 8%, 9%. That depends on your tax liability. Okay.
Yes.
In some other chapter, specifically in TDS chapter, okay, I wanted one concept called marginal relief, maximum marginal rate, MMR. That is also a rate, MMR. Sir, then why are you teaching us in basic concept? Because sometimes they ask, theory of MMR in basic concept. This concept is relevant to which chapter? Last chapter, you know, the TDS chapter. There it is useful. Okay. So what is MMR? MMR is maximum marginal rate. Maximum
marginal rate.
Maximum marginal rate means is the highest tax rate applicable to an individual assessee in India. Highest tax rate. You tell me, what is the highest income tax rate applicable to assessee? Income tax. 30%. Take 30 on Kelsey. Take 30 on Kelsey. 30. You took 30 on Kelsey. Plus sign hai wahan pe. Plus. Highest surcharge. Surcharge is on tax rate. 15%. 15% ka button hoga wahan pe. 15%. 30 plus 15%. So 45 nahi aana chahiye. 34.5. This is 15% of 30% automatically got added. Now, this is income tax plus surcharge. On this figure, we pay 4% cess. He says, okay, add plus 4%. 35.88 is your MMR in India. So if someone asks what is MMR, so you cannot by heart, okay, 35.88. You should know the way of computing it. In India, MMR is 35.88. But how did we reach to that number? 30% plus 15% plus 4%. That's number we have as a MMR. Okay. Sir, where to use it in TDS chapter? That use I will tell you later. But if someone asks you what is MMR, or even if I ask you what is MMR, so you should be knowing what is MMR in India. This is the highest tax rate applicable to individual. Sometimes we need to punish assessee. So we tell them, now your tax rate will be MMR. You will not get that benefit of 5%, 10%. Directly tax rate will be MMR. So what is MMR? 35.88%. Highest tax rate applicable to any random individual. Okay? Okay?
Yes.
So here we are done with our basic concepts other than section 9. I will teach you, allow me to teach you section 9 from ICA chart. Okay, that chart I will put. Because your institute has not given summary. They have written everything in detail. At intermediate level, you don't have to read in that detail. Even if you can understand the chart, okay, that's enough. Okay, so do you want break?
Yes.
So take some short break, and then after break we are going to start section 9, very important section.